So hi, hello and welcome again, Microbehunter here, and today in this video I would like to show you the effect that the different mounting media have on the specimen quality of a microscope slide. So what we see here, this is a wet mount, so that's the original specimen. It shows diatoms, it's a water sample. You can see in the background quite a bit of movement going on as well, and I'm showing this to you as a reference, okay? Because what I've done is I've taken the same sample and I allowed it to dry, and then I mounted the slide with either glycerin gelatin or Euparal mounting medium. And those two mounting media are significantly different from each other. It will basically also change the way that the specimen looks like. So currently I'm looking at the specimen using a 60x objective, and I'm going to be using the same objective also for the other two slides, and we're gonna compare them. And I think it's quite interesting what we're able to see here. So I'm going to now show you the slide mounted in glycerin gelatin. So this here is now the slide mounted in glycerin gelatin. We see that those round structures here, these are bubbles. Glycerin gelatin is notorious because bubbles are difficult to avoid, so you have to be kind of careful when you make them. But essentially, look, it looks perfectly nice. You see the green chloroplasts inside of the diatoms, and that's important because later on, when I show you the one mounted in Euparal, it's going to be quite a bit different. So in here, you have the chloroplasts, and these are the individual diatoms here. Quite nice, and the glycerin gelatin is able to preserve the specimen's characteristics reasonably well. Of course, no movement. That's a permanent slide, so in that sense we are missing a little bit on the natural appearance of a water sample where you have bacteria and other microorganisms swimming around. Also some of the gliding diatoms we're not able to see here because of course it's everything is kind of locked in place here. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add now to the stage above the same specimen but now mounted in Euparal mounting medium, and let's have a look how that looks like. Okay, so that is now mounted in Euparal, same specimen, and we can already see quite a big difference here, right? Look how the diatoms look like. Just for comparison again, so this is again the one mounted in glycerin gelatin, and here Euparal mounting medium again. One of the most notable things is of course that we're not able to see now the individual chloroplasts. Let me switch on the arrow again. So you see that the diatoms, the diatom shells look quite empty now. I mean, there are a couple of a few that I've seen where the chloroplasts, the green chloroplasts, are still visible up here, a little bit more green, right? No comparison to the other slide here, which I mounted in glycerin gelatin. But maybe you are able to see something else as well. Besides the apparent lack of the chloroplasts, and I'm going to explain why this is the case in just a minute. You're probably also going to notice that the background is quite a bit more greenish yellowish than the specimen mounted in glycerin gelatin. Right, so and that's essentially shows already that the Euparal mounting medium apparently seems to do something to the diatoms, and this is kind of now the mystery revealed. Euparal mounting medium contains an organic solvent, and the solvent dissolves the green pigment, the chlorophyll, from the diatoms, right, from the chloroplasts. And this green pigment, because it's dissolved, it goes into the Euparal mounting medium changes the background color. So the mounting medium therefore has a direct impact, a chemical impact on the specimen. And for this reason, the choice of the mounting medium is very critical because it really depends on what you want to show, right? If you just are okay with the fact that the cells lose their color because it dissolves, well then fine, and you use Euparal. But actually, normally you don't want this to happen. You want to preserve the natural original state, and then you have to use a mounting medium that's based on water. And glycerin gelatin is one of those mounting media that is essentially water-based. Now, each of those mounting media also has its own advantages and other advantages and disadvantages. And one of the disadvantages of glycerin gelatin is this what you see over here, right? The bubbles. It's difficult to use this mounting medium because you have to warm it up. So you have to melt the mounting medium and then it becomes liquid. Bubbles starts to appear. Yeah, so you have to be kind of careful when making the permanent slide. Yeah, so in that sense, it's a little bit more difficult to process. Yeah, here we are again with the Euparal, right? And Euparal generally is not the mounting medium of choice for mounting water samples. It's the mounting medium of choice for mounting insects because Euparal has the nice advantage that the exoskeleton, which is the outer part of the insect, starts to become more transparent. So entomologists, these are the insect researchers, they use Euparal mounting medium for mounting their insects. Yeah, so I just also wanted to show you now the mounting medium itself I've been using. Yeah, so that's Euparal, right? Yeah, it's already expired back in 2013, but it's still usable. Yeah, so here you see it's a little bit it has to be still I can dilute it with a little bit of alcohol, and this one over here, that is glycerin gelatin, and you see it's solid, right? And it's solid because I have to melt it at 40 degrees, and also the slide has to be pre-warmed, and you can see already over here there are some bubbles as well. Just wanted to show you the effect that mounting media indeed have on the specimen, and that therefore the choice of mounting medium is strongly influenced by actually what you want to, not only what you want to show, but also on specimen, has an impact on specimen stability. Okay, so enough for today. I hope that you found this short video informative. If you like these type of videos, then please consider subscribing. Please also drop a comment below if you have your own views on the whole issue. In any case, I wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting as always, and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.